Good morning, children. Welcome back to online classes. So, children, previous class we have discussed about the types of food. So, in that we discussed about the carbohydrates and fats, proteins, vitamins, and minerals. Yeah, no, children. So, let me revise all those things. Then I will continue the lesson. Okay, children. Now tell me, children, why the growing children should eat more proteins? Tell me, children, why growing children should eat the more protein? Yes, because the proteins are the nutrients. It play a very important role in building our bodies. Building our bodies. Hence, it's called bodybuilding food, and they also help to maintain it, replacing or we say repairing worn out tissue. So the growing children should eat the more protein. It helps to build our body, and plus it helps to repair our worn out tissues. Okay, children. Next, why we should eat the plenty of fruits and green vegetables? Tell me why we should eat. Because in the fruits and green vegetables, it protects us from the diseases, and also it's rich in vitamins and minerals. So we should eat the plenty of fruits and green vegetables. Why the vitamins and minerals are called the protective food? Why vitamins and minerals are called protective food, children? Tell me. Because vitamins and minerals protect us from diseases. They protect us from the diseases, and also it helps to do the proper function in our body. So this food is also called, which food? Vitamins and minerals are also called the protective food. Okay, children. Sometimes the bodybuilders who will do the physical work, you know, they should eat the more carbohydrate. They should eat the more carbohydrate because carbohydrate gives us energy. It gives us energy. It is energy giving food. So we should eat the more carbohydrate. More carbohydrate means what should eat then? We should eat the potato, sweet potatoes, then ghee, oil, butter, you know, bread, milk. These all the things we should eat, then only we will get the carbohydrate. So who will do the physical exercise? They should need the more carbohydrate because it gives us energy. You know, children? So these all the things we have discussed in the previous class, children. You know? Now today we'll see the milk is complete food. Milk is complete food.
Okay, children.
milk. Curd is very good for our stomach. It's yummy and good for our tummy also, because it is a curd is the source of protein and minerals like a calcium. So it makes our bones very strong. Bones and teeth very strong. So curd also very good for our health. So not only the milk, we should eat the curd also, which is rich in protein and minerals. Okay, it's like calcium only. So we have to eat the curds also, which is very yummy and good for our tummy. Clear, children? So this is about the milk and curd. Remember, children, every day at least one type of fruits and vegetables you have to eat. The next we'll see, what is a balanced diet food? What is the meaning of a balanced diet food? A balanced diet food. So what is the a balanced diet food? We know it that the human beings need various nutrients in certain and the specific amount. So they should eat the all kind of food items. A diet that contains all nutrients, proteins in the appropriate amount is called balanced diet food. Whatever food we will eat, children, it contains all, or we say it contains maximum amounts of the proteins and nutrients, and that is called the balanced diet food. So here I will show the one image, just you can see. Here you can see, children, it is a complete diet food. You know, one side vegetables, then fish, meat, milk, butter, cheese, rice, pulses, everything is there. So this is called a balanced diet food. A food that contains all essential nutrients in the appropriate amount is called a balanced diet food. Clear, children? So everything you should eat, not only the fruits, even though you should have the all the green vegetables also. Clear, children? So this is called the complete balanced diet food. Yes. So for that only your mother will prepare rice, dal, one kind of vegetables, then chapati, roti, then curd also she will give. That is called the complete balanced diet food. We will get all kinds of proteins and nutrients in the appropriate amount, in the specific amount. Clear, children? So here you have to eat all kinds of vegetables also. Should not leave the leafy vegetables, spinach, palak, we say, methi. So everything you should eat. So in that, there is a numbers of proteins and vitamins. Clear, children? The next is, what is the food pyramid? Food pyramids means what, children? So how we should eat the food? It is planned. A balanced diet can be planned using a food pyramid. A food pyramid is divided into the section. It is depending upon the serving, or we say it is depending upon the quantity of different food items, which food and which vegetables when to eat. So that is called the food pyramid. Okay children, so here I will show you what is the food pyramid. So children, this is called the food pyramid. You can see here that food can be planned using a food pyramid. A food pyramid is divided into the section. You can see a section which is depending on the servings. Means what? The quantity of intake. Means whatever we have to take, we have to eat for different food items, which keeps our body healthy. You can see that down here, the first row, here you can see the first row. What is there? Bread, cereals, potato, pasta, rice. Then in that all five food items, you have to at least 3 to 2 items every day you have to eat, because it's rich in vitamins and minerals. The next you can see the fruits and vegetables. So every day one kind of fruits and the two kinds of vegetables you have to eat. Next is the milk, cheese, butter, curd is there. So these things also every day, drink the milk, eat the curd. That is a good for your health because it contains the vitamins and minerals, which is a good for our bones and teeth. Next you can see the meat, egg, dry fruits, fish. You know children, these items you have to cook and eat. Next you can see the up, it is a oil. You know, that is called the fat food. And the top you can see the chocolates, foods and drinks high in the fat. Like in the chocolate, we will get the too much fat. So this is called the food pyramid. So these things you have to eat daily. See this down, and vegetable, fruits, bread, everything. And then this top you can see the chocolates. This is the fat food. So we should not eat the daily chocolates. Clear children? Because it is not good for our health. Yes children, so this is called the food pyramid. Okay children, so every day eat the vegetables, fruits. It's very important for your health children, who are especially the children. Small children, they should eat the vegetable fruits, and daily they should drink the milk also. So some important things children, always we have to cooked food, we have to cook and eat. Why the food should be cooked? Because whatever germs is there, that germs died when you are cooking, when you are boiling, that things, that germs, it's died in that only. So we have to cook also. Now, importance of cooked food. Some food we can't eat the raw only. We have to cook, like the rice, potato, brinjal, cereals, pulses, some kind of vegetables. We have to cook and eat only. Raw we cannot eat. Yeah, no, children? So next we see the importance of cooked food. vegetables and pulses we have to cooked and ate. Take an example of pulses. Dal you say. You know, moong dal, tur dal. This all the things we have to cooked and ate. Should not eaten by raw only. You know, like a brinjal, pochacho, drumstick. This all the vegetables also we have to cooked and eat. Some animal products like fish, meat, egg, we should cooked and eat. You know? So these are called the cooked items. So what some kinds of vegetables I said? You know, children, vegetables like potato. You know, then tell me, yes, potato, brinjal, then yes, I will write down. Drumstick, and then in that pulses, you can see the pulses. Pulses means what, children? Here, dal. You say the dal, no? So this item we have to cook and eat. Sometime your mother will prepare dal, no? Kadi, no? So these all the items we have to cook and eat. We cannot eat the raw only. So next, what is there? Some animal products also. Some animal. Some animal product also. We have to cook and eat. What is that animal product? Tell me, children. Like meat. You know? Meat. Then egg. And fish. This food we have to, animal product also, we have to cooked and eat. Yes, this is the cooked food. And sometimes what will happen, we will use the oil, ghee, sugar and the salt. Why we will add this all the things? Because we want to improve the taste, and for the flavor we will add the sugar, oil and the ghee in the food only. Clear, children? So this food item should be what? It's a cooked. We should cook and eat this all the food items. Animal product also, some kind of vegetables and pulses also we have to cook and eat, children. And we will use the oil, ghee, butter, sugar and the salt we will add to improve the taste and the flavor of the food. If in that food there is a no salt only, you can eat, you cannot eat. So the salt brings the flavor for that food. If your mother is preparing the kheer, if in that no sugar only, you can eat? No, because it is a sweetless only. So sugar make that kheer very yummy. It's give the flavor. So this oil, ghee and sugar and salt we will add in the food for flavor. Clear, children? So we are cooking this all the things, this all the food items we have to cook. So what is the benefit of cooking the food? What is the benefit of cooking of food, children? Tell me. When you cook this food like potato, brinjal, drumstick, pulses, what will happen? That food becomes soft and it is easier to digest. You know, children? That food becomes soft and what? It is easier to digest. It is easier to digest. You know? Next, second, what is there? What is the useful? What is the benefit? What is the advantages of cooking food? Cook food we can keep for longer time. You know, food can be preserved for a long time. You know, it's She prepare morning rice till the night. It's a good only. Never we can eat. It's not a spoil. If your mother prepare any kind of vegetables, dal, if it is cooked, then we can keep for long time. We can keep for long time till the night. We can keep tomorrow also. You know, that is what? It's a preserved for a long time. Clear, children? Again, when you cook that potato or brinjal or drumstick, the food makes the tastier. It comes the taste. You know, cooked also make the food tastier. When you eat the kacha, that potato, raw leafy, it means it comes taste? No. Just if you cooked that potato and brinjal, then it comes taste. You can eat very easily. You know? Again, what is that? The next? Next, what is that? When you cook that food, most of the microorganisms are destroyed while cooking. So, what is the next? Tell me, children, most of the microorganism, most of the micro, most of the microorganisms are destroyed. So these are the benefit. I will say destroyed. I will write here while cooking. Yes. So these are the advantages of cooking food. What is that advantages? Food becomes soft and it is easier to digest. It's preserved for a long time. Cooked food can be kept for long time. Most of the microorganisms destroyed while cooking the food. So these are the advantages, or you say benefit for the cooking food. Then what is the disadvantages of cooking food? Tell me, children. Any idea? Benefit we got, advantages we got. What is the disadvantages? Tell me. When you cook the food, most of the vitamins and minerals destroyed. Most of the vitamins and minerals, it's a destroyed because of a high temperature. You know? Next, what is that? Tell me. We are using too much oil, butter, ghee. You know, that makes the food very fat rich. Sometimes when your mother is preparing the vegetables or any sweet items, what your mother will do? She will add the more butter, more ghee she will add. And that time what happens? That food becomes the rich in fat, and that is a not good for our health. Yes. So these are the disadvantages of the food while cooking. Sometimes when your mother will prepare the palak, methi, what will happen? That vegetables, that leafy vegetables, they are contains in water. They have the water contents of vegetables. When you cook that, all the leafy vegetables, what will happen? It get reduced because of cooking only. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಮ್ಮಿ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಪಾಲಕ್ ತಂದಿದ್ದೆ, ಪಾಲಕ್ ಮೆಥಿ ಇಷ್ಟು ತಂದಿದ್ದೆ, ನೀ ಅದು ಕುಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಪಾಲಕ್ ಪಾಲಕ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮೆಥಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಇಷ್ಟೆಲ್ಲ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ. ಯಾಕೆ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ವೈಲ್ ಕುಕ್ಕಿಂಗ್. ಹೌದಿಲ್ಲ? ಎಲ್ಲ ವಾಟರ್ ಹೋಗಿದೆ, ಬರೇ ಅಷ್ಟನ ನಿಮಗೆ ಅದು ಪಲ್ಲೆ ಸಿಗ್ತೆ. ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಜಿಟೇಬಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ cooking. So these are the disadvantages. What is the disadvantages? First one, most of the proteins and vitamins destroyed while cooking in the high temperature. The next one is the too much uses of ghee, butter and the oil makes the food very fat rich. That is a bad for our health. Third one is the water content of vegetables get reduced because of cooking only. So these are the disadvantages of cooking food. Okay, children. So next, so these are the cooking food. So remember, children, whatever your mother will prepare, the food, that food should be covered. It should not be open. If you keep the open, then what will happen? Tell me. What will happen? Tell me. See here. Let me show the image. See, this is the uncovered food. You can see here. It's a. You can see this food is open or it is uncovered. Where you can see the numbers of flies. You know. Yes, you can see the numbers of fly sit on your open food only. And a few second, if you keep the open only for a few second, numbers of germs, they will sit on your food. So within a second, they will leave the many germs on this food. And when we eat the same food, the numbers of germs, it's go in our stomach. So remember, children, whatever food your mother is preparing, it should be covered only. And one more thing, the food is cooked in a clean kitchen will be healthy and safe to eat. And one more thing, children, when you are drinking the water also in the glass, see, that glass also should be covered on, it should not be open. And always use the water which is filtered and boiled. Don't use the water which is not filtered, not a boiled, can have a numbers of germs. You can see the numbers of germs. These germs will cause disease. Clear, children? So, a fly which sits on your foot for a few seconds can leave the numbers of germs, and these germs can make you sick. So, tell to your mother, keep the kitchen, wherever your mother is preparing the food, that room, that kitchen should be very clean. And when she prepares the food, that food should be covered, it should not be open. One more thing, drink the water which is filtered or boiled. It's a very good for your health, children. So there is some good habits are there. Good food habits, we say. There is some good food habits are there. So before meal means what? Before breakfast, before lunch, before dinner, you have to wash your hand with soap or with liquid. Clear, children? Next one, drink the plenty of water. That keeps your digestion system very good. Eat the plenty of fruits and green vegetables. Do not eat more food whichever we will get on the roadside. Avoid the junk food, bakery items. You should avoid the junk food. Clear, children? Eat healthy food, not Lay's chips and burger in the meals means in the lunch time and in the dinner time. You should not have the junk food like kachori, samosa, bhajji. Especially in the meals time, you have to eat the complete and the healthy food. That is a rice, chapati, vegetable, fruits, everything you should be eat. And especially one more thing, children, trim your nails. The nail should be cut because dirt you done under the nails that may contains the numbers of germs. So weekly 2 times you have to cut your or trim your nails also. Avoid eating the too many chocolates. You should not eat the too many chocolates because chocolate contains the sugar and fats. So you should not eat the too many chocolates. It spoils your tooth also. Don't read the books when the TV is on. Clear, children? Eat in the light only. Should not eat the food in the darkness. Always remember, children, food should be eaten in the light only, not in the darkness, because we don't know in the darkness how many insects are sitting on our food. So eat in the light and read also in the light only, should not in the dark. So these are the some good food habits. Chewing your food very well, should not swallow it. Half of chapati don't put inside. Nicely chew that food, make a small pieces and then swallow it. So these are the good food habits, children. Okay, so I have finished this unit now, children. Unit 1, healthy food. In this lesson we have discussed the numbers of things. So remember, children, always eat the food, always eat the healthy food only, and every day you should drink the plenty of water. At least one vegetables and fruits you have to eat, and avoid the roadside food. Clear? So this is our today's class, children. So children, whatever I have finished, based on that, I have given the homework for you, children. So this is the homework for you, children, here. Activity: classify these food items under the correct heading. So I have given curd, pulses, spinach, etc. You have to classify which items comes in the carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals. So here, carbohydrate means what here, like a bread, potato, rice, it comes in the carbohydrate. Protein means curd, pulses, milk, egg is protein. Fat food, milk, ghee, butter, it's a fat. And vitamins and minerals, vegetables and fruits comes in the vitamins and minerals. So this activity you have to do in the EVS notebook, and then finally send me in the app, children. So you have to make a 4 columns also. Clear, children? Make a 4 columns and then correctly classify all those food items. Okay, children? Thank you.